I hope all of you are ready for this nonstop action. This is part two. This is the darkness number two. Let's get going.
Fuck. Why do I keep seeing Journey?
Leads me.
Thank you.
elevators to come after you, Jackie. They come on back to Wall Street.
You're just a low-life punk, Swifty. Who the fuck put you up to this?
You think I wanted to mess with you? Come on, I had no choice. You stubborn prick. Are you even listening to what I'm saying?
You better start talking.
I think they're like some kind of secret club or something, you know? They gave me an envelope with a whole load of cash in it. their boss, their leader, whatever. I met him in a brothel, the Brimstone Club, all right? Look, I'm telling you, these guys are some kind of...
Hey, what the fuck are you doing?
Jack, you miserable fucking...
What the fuck did you do? I needed him. I needed answers.
It was nothing.
Once the darkness gets a hold of you, you start to lose control. You start to wonder what the fuck you're doing. Time slips away from you. And then, all of a sudden, it's like you're sitting in a theater, watching a movie of your own life. And you're up there on the big screen, big as life. You're a fucking movie star, and you're killing all the bad guys, tearing them limb from limb. And you feel good, you look good. Fuck, you are good. And then you realize something. Everyone else in the theater, they're screaming, because they're watching a horror movie. And you're not the hero. You're the monster.
Eddie and Frank are checking out the Brimstone right now. And the new guy's found your buddy, Johnny Powell. Yeah, he didn't take the invitation so good. We put him in the back room so he could shit his pants for a while. Follow me.
Can't wait to see him again.
Yeah, it's me. These guys are a couple clowns short of a circus, Jackie. He wasn't living by the Queensboro Bridge. He was living under it, in a cardboard box. All right, come on. He's back here. Hey, Chief, how's the wife and kids? Well, he's in a good mood. There you go.
Knock yourself. This is what's a big house and you own some books. I mean, some other fuck nuts might live at the North Pole and they own a...
Johnny Powell. You look like shit. You were supposed to be the expert. I paid you good money to help me figure things out, and you repaid me by skipping out in the middle of the night? For what?
Jackie, I did what I could to help you control the darkness. But being around you was becoming a problem for me. The darkness is so fucking seductive. I could hear it whispering to me whenever I was around you. It was starting to change me. Are you gonna kill me? Is that what this is all about?
I let it out, Johnny. Now I don't know if I can control it.
You let the darkness back out? Jesus Christ, Jackie, that thing is like a slow suicide.
Then help me get it back under control.
You don't control the darkness, Jackie. You cower in fucking fear of it, and you pray it goes away. The longer the darkness is active, the more it'll try to confuse you. It'll try to trap you, make you see stuff that other people can't see.
I need your help, so you're back on the payroll until I say you can go. Bunch of assholes just came after my entire operation. And whoever gave them this envelope is connected to the darkness somehow. I need you to figure out who they are and what they know about it.
Okay. Okay, yeah, I'll do what I can. It'll go a lot faster if you get one of your gorillas to untie me. Please? It lives in Viscera, and you are the focus. It wants chaos.
You can untie him now, Chief. But keep an eye on him for me, would you?
Oh, that guy really let himself go. I used to think he was pretty smart. Now he looks like something the cat threw up. Hey, Frank and Eddie are back from the club. They're waiting for you with Jimmy in your office.
All right. Thanks, Vin.
How you holding up, Jackie?
I'm all right, Aunt Sarah. How you doing?
I have arthritis and two bum knees. Every day is a gift. How do you think I'm doing?
You're something else, you know that?
And you look like shit, you know that? I'm gonna make you some of that meatloaf you love so much. I'll have it for you in a couple of hours. Nice home-cooked meal is what you need.
You're the best.
Bet your ass I am.
Swifty prick was right. The assholes who hit us are hiding out at the Brimstone.
What did you geniuses find out?
It was Eddie who heard it. I was otherwise engaged at the time.
He was busy snorting coke off of Hooker's ass.
Never could multitask.
Well, these two chuckleheads are getting their dick spit polished, one of the whores starts running her mouth about the new owners.
I had this girl, Camille. She says the place got bought up last month. The new guys took over the top floor.
Yeah, but that ain't the best part. Camille says she's seen some weird guy with a limp go in and out of the place. Says he looks like Nosferatu on crack.
Who the fuck is Nosferatu?
Your grandmother.
No idea if this whack job and his crew are still there. But it might be worth checking out.
All right, enough talking. I'm headed down there.
Whatever you say, Jaggy. I think Vinny has a friend who works there. Might want to ask him about her.
Hey, Jack. So, Jimmy told me about the Brimstone Club. Sounds like a real dumpster.
You got a hookup over there?
Well, you mean me? Well, I'd never go to a cesspool like that, but I got a friend who goes there sometimes. Who, you know, when it's late at night, when other places are closed. I know a girl there named Venus. Sure, she can help you out. She's a real handful. Two of them, actually. The new owners are real pissy about the door. They don't let nobody bring a gun in. That's fine, though, because you probably want to learn as much as you can before you... You know, do your thing and scare the living shit out of him?
Damn right.
Okay, then. You ready to get some fucking answers?
Take me to this shithole, Vinny.
I thought you'd never ask. Let's go.
Jackie, wait!
What? What's the matter?
This envelope... Where did you say you got it again?
Off some dead guy that was paid to kill me.
Oh, shit.
Something wrong, Johnny?
Nothing. Couldn't be them. Because I'd be really bad. I gotta do some more research. Good luck in your killing spree.
Me and the boys will take him to the zoo while you're gone. Retards like the zoo.
Let's go, Vinny.
Attaboy, Jackie. What do you say we go tweak some nipples and see what happens, huh?
I remember this one time, when it was summer, hot as balls. Jenny and me were on the stoop with a couple of cones there trying to cool off. And here comes this fucking kid. You know the type. Asshole all the way. He shoves me over and takes a seat between the two of us. Jenny takes one look at him, dumped her cone right in his lap. That's when he pushed her. So I did what I had to do. I curbed the little fuck. Figured a few months eating through a straw would teach him how to talk to a lady. Jenny didn't talk to me for a week. I think so, Chief. I'm sure you'd remember.
I gotta frisk you, tough guy.
Yes, that's good. Arms to your sides.
This is a friendly joint. No trouble. You packing tonight, hotshot?
Who, me? And spoil a party?
Yes, he's coming.
Head inside. Have a nice evening.
Right through this door, pal.
Can make all your dreams come true.
Turn around. The action's that way.
Wake up. What did I tell you?
Huh? Why the?
You looking for a good time?
You must be Venus. I'm Jackie, Vinny's friend.
Well, any friend of Vinny's is a friend of mine. Why don't you come up to my room? I think I could arrange something special just for you. Follow me, handsome.
Yes.
Wife ever do this?
Okay, listen up. There's no cameras in these elevators, but we ain't got much time. I stashed Vinny's gun in my room. If these new guys find it, they'll kill me. They don't play games, Jackie. These are some messed up fucking people. They all tweaked out and shit. Just promise if anything goes wrong, you won't rat me out. So you gotta get up to the third floor quickly. Are you listening to me?
Yeah. I got it.
Come on, it's this way. Something for you. They closed off the top two floors. We figured they was just shooting pornos up there. But then Chantel went to go see that hunchback guy on the third floor. Now we ain't seen her in a month. Here, this is from Vinny.
Nice.
Now you go find these assholes and make sure you give them one for me. Shoot Quasimodo upside the head and put us all out of his fucking misery.
Job sucks.
Can you get up to that vent?
Right, gonna need your help here. Close your peepers a tick.
Wait, what did you do?
Neat little trick, innit? Now you see what I see, don't you? House of you!
Short. Let's get moving.
What's he on about?
Open this door, and I'll ask him myself.
Yeah, pretty sure that's bad.
Yeah. Something's not right here. Find the rest of these assholes. It's just like Swifty said. These guys know everything about me.
Go no further.
Jackie!
Wish God shines upon him. Do it.
Burn, host!
So predictable. Prepare the siphon.
He's coming to you.
What the hell are you doing?
He's awake. Good. Keep him focused. I like the way he feels. He feels sticky.
Go about your duties. When the transfer is complete, then we'll have what we came for.
I want you to believe me. I wish this could have been any other way, Jackie. But we all have tough choices to make, and this is yours.
So you're the fucker who tried to hit us at the restaurant, huh?
Don't talk, and don't think. Just listen. You've been keeping something that was once lost. Something that doesn't belong to you. Now you have to choose to give it back. What happens to you is of secondary concern. I only care about one thing.
I want the darkness.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Of course you don't. But the fact is, you're careless. And far too many criminals in this city believe you have a demon living inside you. The restaurant was a test to be certain you were the new darkness host. Now you've passed that test, we want it back. I feel you shifting in there. Are you getting nervous? You're too stupid to give the darkness the fear and respect it deserves, Jackie. It prefers the company of a moron it can control, and it loathes the sight of an intelligent man who can control it. Now I'll ask just once. Will you give me the darkness of your own free will?
Why don't you try and take it if you're such a fucking genius?
If you read anything but comic books and menus, you'd know there are rules. The host may only give up the darkness by choice. I'm afraid I have to help you make that choice. Mr. Peevish, if you'd be so kind.
Watch this, pretty boy. It's your own personal snuff movie.
The darkness made you watch your girlfriend's murder. Your first meaningful act as its host was one of submission. Face it, Jackie. You can't control the darkness, and you never could. Best to give it back to the people who can. That stream of dark essence flowing into the siphon tells me you're already thinking of giving it up. Let's see if I can grease the wheels of that decision. Mr. Bragg.
So, this was your girlfriend, huh, Jackie boy? I guess whores with lip rings give good head. What's the matter? Couldn't fuck her face when her head was blown off?
Jackie! Oh, Jackie, the whole damn place is overrun!
Don't give an inch, Jackie. They don't got the whole place yet. Shut up!
You're under attack all across the city. We have the means and the intent to bring your organization to its knees, and within minutes, we'll control your home. So think fast, Jackie. This isn't just about you anymore. Make a choice, left or right.
That one got wet.
You did what you had to do, Jackie. You show these bastards what they just fuck with. Shut your ugly mouth, you fucking corpse.
You made a bad decision to let the genie back out of the bottle, Jackie. To the darkness, you're just a puppet made of skin and gristle. Last chance. Will you give me the darkness of your own free will?
Fuck you!
Then not of your own free will. I'm trying to help you, but if you're too stupid to see it, I'll negotiate in a language even you can understand.
Mr. Bragg, kill everyone in the mansion. Find the old lady and tear off both of her arms.
Hey, how about I tear off her useless old tits? What do you think of that, Jackie boy?
You lost Jenny because you couldn't control the darkness. And now you're going to lose everything you cherish because you don't have the sense to accept your limitations. Break his will. He will beg us to take it from him.
You must resist.
Jenny's dead, you idiot. Focus! Give me the darkness, or your dear old Aunt Sarah is worm food.
I can't.
You leave me no choice but to use the siphon, Mr. Peevish.
The binding rituals are nearly prepared. Won't be long now.
Good. Keep working him over. I want him as weak as possible when the ritual begins.
Resist.
Peevish, the siphon! Get outside and lock the fucking door! I tried to give you an out, Jackie, so don't ever say you weren't given a choice. You bought this on yourself. And you've bought it on your family. I was only trying to help you. You won't die, Jackie. The darkness won't let you. But by the time you get out, your Aunt Sarah will be gutted and boned, and you'll have gained nothing. Think about just how powerless you are, because next time, I won't ask so nicely.
Torch the entire building!
Jenny!
Thank you.
Butch! Up here!
Holy shit, Jackie! We thought you were done for!
I know! I gotta
get... Jackie! They took the mansion! They're gonna kill everybody!
Fuck! Meet me up ahead! I'll find my way down!
The siphon! It will make us complete!
Shut up! She cries,
Jackie!
Thank you.
There was this priest that used to come around the orphanage, Father Alonso.
Yeah, I know what you're thinking, and it ain't that kind of story.
Anyway, must have been about 1,000 years old or something, real fire and brimstone type of guy.
Used to tell us kids that hell wasn't some bullshit story they made up to keep us in line. It was fucking real. A fucked up place, where all the deadbeats, hookers, dealers, and junkies all ended up. And if we weren't careful, that's exactly where we were gonna go.
Fuck. If only it were that easy.
Yes! Rip them to pieces!
Let's go. Jesus, am I glad to see you. These guys came in like a bunch of fucking cockroaches. They're out of their minds.
And you're not?
I'm still alive, ain't I? More than can be said for these limp dick fucks when I'm done with them. You better head upstairs, boss. I got you covered down here. I ain't bleeding that bad. The elevator's coming down. Don't let anyone...